Hello dear learners, very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss about the proton pump inhibitors. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the introduction of proton pump inhibitors, mode of action, drug belongs to PPIs, use and side effects of proton pump inhibitors. Introduction: the final step in acid secretion in the parietal cell is the pumping of protons into the lumen of stomach by the membrane H+K+ATPase pump as described in mode of action of H2 blockers. So inhibition of this proton pump act beyond the site of action of second messengers like calcium and cyclic AMP and is independent of the action of secretagogues, histamine, gastrin and acetylcholine. Therefore, acid pump inhibitors block both basal and stimulated acid secretion. In 1972, a group of Swedish medicinal chemists discovered that certain pyridyl methyl benzimidazole sulfides were capable of functioning as H+K+ATPase or proton pump inhibitors. These compounds were subsequently converted to sulfoxide derivatives, which exhibited highly potent irreversible inhibition of the proton pump. The benzimidazole proton pump inhibitors are products that are rapidly converted to a sulfinamide intermediate in the highly acidic environment of gastric parietal cells. The weakly basic benzimidazole proton pump inhibitors accumulate in this acidic compartment on the luminal side of the parietal cells. Now, mode of action. The benzimidazole proton pump inhibitors are then chemically converted by acid to a sulfinamide intermediate that inhibits the proton pump via covalent interaction with sulfyl hydryl group with cysteine residue of the H+K+ATPase pump. All of the PPIs have been shown to react with cysteine 813 of pump, but some bind to additional pump sulfyl hydryl residue as well. Means most of proton pump inhibitors are bind to cysteine sulfahydryl group at the position of 813. For example, omeprazole and esomeprazole also react with cysteine 892 and pantoprazole with cysteine 822 and lansoprazole to cysteine 321. Cysteines 321, 813 and 822 are all in the proton transport domain of the H+K+ATPase system. This is the conversion of benzimidazole proton pump inhibitors into the sulfinamide derivative, and this sulfinamide derivatives bind with the sulfhydryl group of H+K+ATPase pump. It inhibit the H+K+ATPase pump. This is the mode of action of the proton pump inhibitors. In proton pump inhibitors, there is an exchange of proton with the K plus, and H plus goes to the lumen of stomach. And proton pump inhibitors inhibit the exchange of proton with the potassium. So that's why it was produced the anti-secretory action. Now, drugs belongs to proton pump inhibitors, omeprazole. So if you check all the drugs belongs to the proton pump inhibitors, they have this is the common structure. This is the benzimidazole nucleus which having a sulfoxide connection. Okay, now omeprazole and its IUPAC name is 5-methoxy-2,4-methoxy-3,5-dimethyl-2-pyridyl-methylsulfinyl-1-H-benzimidazole. Omeprazole is approved for treatment of heartburn, gastroesophageal reflux disease, it is commonly called as GERD, duodenal ulcer, erosive esophagitis, gastric ulcer, and pathological hypersecretory conditions. Esomeprazole magnesium, it is a S isomer of omeprazole, it is also its IUPAC name is S-base-5-methoxy-2-S-4-methoxy-3-5-dimethyl-2-pyridyl-methylsulfinyl-1-H-benzimidazole-1-E-magnesium trihydrate.
इज एस इनान्सियोमर ऑफ ओमेप्राजोल एंड द एस आइसोमर ओमेप्राजोल हैज स्लाइटली ग्रेटर प्रोटॉन पम्प इनहिबिटर एक्टिविटी, मींस इसोमेप्राजोल इज मोर एक्टिव कंपेयर टू ओमेप्राजोल, व्हाइल ओमेप्राजोल इज अ रेजिमिक मिक्सचर ऑफ। नेक्स्ट ड्रग इन दिस ग्रुप इज लैंसोप्राजोल, सो यू कैन सी हियर अगेन इट इज अ बेंजिमिडाजोल न्यूक्लियस सल्फोक्साइड कनेक्शन एंड पिरिडिल रिंग सिस्टम, ओके। एंड इट्स आइपेक नेम इज 2,3-methyl-4-2,2,2,2 डाइफ्लोरोइथोक्सी 2-pyridyl-methylsulfinyl-1-H-benzimidazole। लाइक अदर प्रोटॉन पम्प इनहिबिटर्स लैंसोप्राजोल इज एसेंशियल अ प्रो ड्रग दैट इन द एसिडिक बायोफेज ऑफ द पेरिटल सेल फॉर्म एन एक्टिव मेटाबोलाइट दैट इरिवर्सिबली इंटरेक्ट विद द टारगेट एटीपेज ऑफ द पम्प। इट इज यूज इन जीआरडी, इरोसिव इसोफेगेटिस, गैस्ट्रिक अल्सर, ड्यूडेनल अल्सर, हाइपरसेक्रेटिव कंडीशंस इंक्लूडिंग जोलिंजर एलिजन सिंड्रोम, पेंटोप्राजोल। अगेन इफ यू कैन चेक हियर, सो बेंजिमिडाजोल मेन न्यूक्लियस इन द पेंटोप्राजोल सोडियम सल्फोनिल कनेक्शन एंड पिरिडिल रिंग सिस्टम। पेंटोप्राजोल सोडियम इट इज अ रेजिमिक सोडियम 5-डाइफ्लोरोमिथोक्सी 2,3,4-dimethoxy 2-pyridyl-methylsulfinyl-1-H-benzimidazole sesquihydrate derivative. It is used in erosive, esophagitis, and pathological hypersecretory condition, including Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. Rabeprazole sodium. It is also racemic mixture, and its IUPAC name is 2,4-3-methoxypropoxy-3-methyl-2-pyridyl. Methyl sulfinyl 1H benzimidazole sodium salt. It is also used in duodenal ulcer, Helicobacter pylori eradication, and erosive or ulcerative GERD. In the rabeprazole, you can also check that benzimidazole ring system is there, sulfinyl connection, and pyridyl heterocycles. Okay. Now, using side effects of proton pump inhibitors, use. These medications are used in the treatment of many conditions such as dyspepsia, peptic ulcer, Helicobacter pylori eradication therapy, gastroesophageal reflux disease, laryngopharyngeal reflux causing laryngitis, chronic cough, Barrett's esophagus, eosinophilic esophagitis, stress, gastritis, and ulcer prevention in critical care. Gastrinomas and other conditions that cause hypersecretion of acid, including Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. Side effects: common adverse effects include headache, nausea, diarrhea, abdominal pain, fatigue, and dizziness. Infrequent adverse effects include skin rash, itch, flatulence, constipation, anxiety, and depression. Also, infrequently, PPI use may be associated with occurrence of myopathies. Thank you.